Google offers a ton of services. There's Google Search, YouTube, Gmail, Drive, but they also offer a cloud platform. And one of the services there is BigQuery. BigQuery is a fast, fully managed enterprise data warehouse for large-scale data analytics. BigQuery can scan terabytes in seconds and petabytes in minutes. A lot of buzzwords, but what is it good for? So it basically is a big data platform and service anybody can use. This is something nobody can do on their personal computer, and BigQuery allows you to do stuff that generally would require some big machines. So here's how it works. You have a question you're looking to answer, and so you write an SQL query for a big data set. You let it run and get the result back. And the other cool thing is, BigQuery comes already with public data sets that you can use. There are huge databases with data on baseball games, census data, crimes, and so forth. You can find some really cool examples to play with out of curiosity, or even use it for a research project. I got really excited when I saw that BigQuery had a public GitHub dataset. For example, somebody ran a query to check how many files use spaces or tabs for indentation. So I thought about what I could do, and I was thinking, people leak their passwords and SSH private keys on GitHub. Maybe they also fail with Bitcoin wallets, their private keys. Maybe that's my way into a luxurious life. So I checked again how a Bitcoin address looks like, built a regular expression for it. Basically, all start with a 5 followed by H, J, or K, and then followed by other base 58 valid characters. And to not match this in random text, I made sure that before this match there is either the start of a line or not a regular character. So spaces or quotes or colons would be fine. Same thing for after the key, just with line ending. Then I looked up some examples that people have done because I'm doing this for the first time. And so I just modified this here a bit. You can also investigate how the dataset looks like you want to query. The fields they have, some details like the size. This is important for what the query will cost. And you can also preview the data to get an idea what you will get. So here's what I came up with. We first query all contents, so all file contents, where this regex matches, and return those matches together with an ID. And then we join this result table with the files database, which contains the repository name and the file name or actual file path. The result will be a table with hopefully Bitcoin wallet keys and where they were from. It takes a few seconds to run those 2 terabytes of data, but returns very quickly a result with over 10,000 matches. Isn't this crazy? We just queried over 2 terabytes of data in a matter of seconds with a regex. 2 terabytes. Anyway, I took the result, downloaded it as a CSV, wrote a simple script using a Python module to get the Bitcoin address for the valid private key, if it was actually a valid private key, and then we use the blockchain info API to see if there are any funds available. But as it turns out, they are mostly empty. Some had some movements in the past, and there was even one with around $5 on it. But when you look where they are from, they are all well-known public or known private keys. They are all like examples from projects and so forth. So unfortunately, my luxurious life has to wait. And actually, this cost me around $5, because while the first terabyte is free, each additional terabyte costs $5, and this dataset had 2 terabytes. Oh well.